what we are going to see, operating principle, block diagram, and particularly PLL IC 565 that we are going to study. And then we'll see the application of PLL. So let us see what is PLL. So before that, some historical background that it was developed in 1930, particularly in communications systems, or we can say satellite communication, it was very powerful and it was used. Earlier, the system was very complex and it was not used to that level, okay? So as it becomes a dedicated IC, that too at a very low cost, this becomes very popular. And nowadays it is being used frequently. There are various ICs available for PLL, particularly we'll study the 565. And the various attractive and other applications include FM demodulator, stereo demodulator, tone detector, frequency synthesizer, etc. So let us see the block diagram of this one. So if you observe the block diagram, it is like a closed loop system. If you observe here, it is completely a closed loop system where are some block diagram, particular sections are there, phase detector, low pass filter, error amplifier, and voltage controlled oscillator. So essentially, PLL, you can say it is comprised of phase detector, low pass filter, error amplifier, and voltage controlled oscillator. So we'll see the functionality of each and every blocks. Here, this voltage control oscillator, it is the center of this, you can say, PLL. Now, what is the job of the voltage control oscillator? Already we have discussed in applications of 555 that VCO means it is a voltage controlled oscillation, means whose oscillations are produced by variation in voltage. So it is like a voltage to frequency converter, means the voltage applied at the input will decide the shift in frequency. Actually, it is a free running multivibrator which runs at a free running frequency, and if there is a error voltage or voltage control voltage is applied, so depending on its magnitude and sign, it shifts its center frequency to either side. If there is a maybe plus voltage, it will shift from FO to some FO plus something F1, depending on the magnitude of VC. If it is negative, it may shift like FO minus F1. So like that, if there is no voltage applied or at a zero voltage, we can say it is running at a free running frequency decided by the resistor and capacitors connected to this block. So that frequency is known as free running frequency, and that frequency will be shifted to either side depending on this voltage applied. So can I say the voltage control oscillator, you understood? Voltage control oscillator समझ में आया क्या?
Yes sir.
Okay. अभी voltage control oscillator यानी कि oscillator है, ठीक है, simple oscillator है, which is giving me some signal with certain frequency. Now it has a property that its oscillations can be changed by means of applied voltage. So this block is used here. Now here actually we are trying to track the input voltage at certain frequency. So that we don't know, okay? So we'll use this VCO, we'll connect the resistor and capacitor in such a way that whatever the frequency we want to track, its frequency should lie in between that one. So you can say we are expecting certain range of frequency to be tracked. Now let us see the function of each and every block. Now here the phase detector, as it says, it detects the phase and the frequency. In a sense, if there is a difference in frequency of input and the feedback, some error voltage will be generated. If there is some difference between input voltage and this. Now presently, this VCO is running at a free running frequency, and this unknown input voltage which is given here with certain, let's say, input amplitude VS and its frequency, let's say source frequency FS. If there is a difference in this frequency, some error voltage will be generated. That is the job of this phase detector. It detects the phase and frequency difference. Essentially, this phase detector is like a mixer, or we can say multiplier. In multiplier, if you have studied in your communication, like amplitude modulation, when you use a multiplier with a modulating signal and a carrier signal, essentially they get a product. Product of this becomes the addition and subtraction of frequency, thereby we get a two sideband. in the same manner, here in the PLL, this phase detector detects the difference between two input frequencies, one coming from the input and one coming from the feedback, and that is the free running frequency. So when there is a difference of frequency of phase, some error voltage is generated. Now it will have the frequencies FS plus minus FO. FS is signal frequency and FO is free running frequency. So this plus and minus, why it is coming, that you might have studied in your communication. When two signals are multiplied, if two signals are having different frequencies, that frequency, there will be two spectrum. There will be two spectrum, two sideband, we can say. In the frequency domain, we will have two spikes. One will be FS plus FO and another will be FS minus FO. Is it clear? यहाँ तक के समझ में आया क्या?
Yes sir.
हाँ. So हम एक तो बताया मैंने VCO, जो कि एक ऑसिलेटर है, कुछ नहीं, जिसको रजिस्टर कैपेसिटर जैसे लगाया उससे ऑसिलेशन मिल रहा है. FO एक फेज डिटेक्टर है, which is acting like a mixer or you can say multiplier. So here unknown input voltage, whose frequency I want to track, I want to capture, so that will be compared in this phase detector. Thereby the error voltage is generated. Why error voltage is generated? If there is a difference in frequency, error voltage will be generated. If they are equal, this error voltage will be zero. Means if the phase difference or frequency difference is more error voltage will be generated. If there is a less difference, less error voltage will be generated. And the error voltage which is generated will have the two frequencies. One will be addition and another will be subtraction. Now the next stage is low pass filter. So we know the job of the low pass filter. It passes the low frequency, whereas it rejects the high frequency. Now in this error voltage, there are two frequency. One is the addition and another is a subtraction. Naturally, the addition voltage or addition component will be more than subtraction. So by this low pass filter, I can say this addition will be rejected and the difference will be passed. So low frequency will be passed and this addition frequency will be rejected, or we can say it will be cut off. So and this signal with frequency FS minus FO will be amplified by this error amplifier. So third stage is error amplifier, and the job of the error amplifier is it amplifies the error signal which is generated due to difference in these two frequencies. So what we have seen, when the unknown voltage is applied, it compares with the free running frequency, the error voltage is generated, which will have two components of frequencies, addition and subtraction, and due to this low pass filter, the addition component will be rejected and only the difference component will be passed on by this low pass filter, and that signal will be amplified by this one, and it will act as a control voltage to this VCO. With this error voltage which is connected to this one, depending on its amplitude, this pre-running frequency FO will now try to increase or decrease depending on this control voltage, whether it is positive or negative, whether its amplitude is more or less, in order these two difference will be lowered. Agar ye FS aur FO mein pehle difference jo 100 hertz ka tha, so it may reach to 90 hertz, and in the all cycles and cycle when it goes on, this now the error voltage will be difference error voltage will be lowered, then it will be control voltage will be lowered, and in such a way all this we can say closed loop actions will make these voltage at the VCO run at the frequency of unknown, and thereby we come to know that the system is locked. That's why the name phase lock loop. This is a loop whereby first the frequency difference will be checked, accordingly error voltage is generated, and that error voltage will be in such a way that this VCO frequency will try to, you can say, track towards the input frequency, and the time will come eventually that both the frequency and after that both the phase will be equal, and thereby the system will be locked onto the input voltage and will say the system is locked. Is it clear to you how it is working, or should I repeat it?
Yes sir, repeat. Yes sir, ek bar repeat.
Yes. Now इसके जब हम लोग समझाने की कोशिश करेंगे, there will be two terms that will come, capture range and lock-in range. Okay? उसके बारे में हम लोग बाद में different देखेंगे, बट फर्स्ट लेट अस सी. सबसे पहले मैंने बताया देयर इज अ वोल्टेज कंट्रोल्ड ऑसिलेटर. तो इसमें जब आर और सी इसके चूज करेंगे उस आर एंड सी के हिसाब से इसका फ्रीक्वेंसी एफओ विल बी जनरेटेड. नाउ व्हेन नो वोल्टेज इज अप्लाइड इट रन एट अ फ्री रनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी. एक ऑसिलेटर के जैसे एक पर्टिकुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी पे वो रन होते रहेगा विच विल बी डिसाइडेड बाई द रजिस्टर एंड कैपेसिटर वी हैव कनेक्टेड. नाउ लेट अस से a unknown input voltage we have connected and we want to capture to lock that frequency. To we don't know what is the frequency of that. It should be within the range. So the job of the phase detector is to see whether there is a difference of frequency and phase is there. If there is a difference of phase or frequency, initially frequency, when both the input signals are of difference of frequency is there, this pre-running frequency and input frequency, error voltage will be generated. So this phase detector essentially works as a mixer, or we can say multiplier. So as we see in the amplitude modulation, when a carrier and modulating signal get multiplied, we get two components. One is a frequency addition and another is a frequency difference. So we see in the frequency spectrum two spikes, we can see two sidebands, we see in the frequency spectrum. If you can recall, if you see the we can see frequency spectrum of amplitude modulation, there it will see a carrier frequency and two spikes of two sideband FC plus FO and FC minus FO, you can say. Similarly here in this, and we can say with this phase detector, when these two signals get multiplied, we get an error voltage. Now this amplitude of error voltage depends on this difference. If the difference is more, the error voltage will be more. Okay, and it will generate two frequencies. One is the addition, another is the difference. At least up to this point, we are clear. Is it? We are clear that in the phase detector, when there is a free-running frequency FO given by VCO and unknown frequency FS by the unknown input, the error voltage is generated, which produces a addition and subtraction of frequency. Now, the next stage is low-pass filter. Naturally, it will pass the low frequency, but it won't allow the high frequency. So the addition frequency, which is well above the cutoff frequency, will be rejected, and the difference of frequency, which is below the cutoff frequency, will be passed. So FS minus FO frequency will be passed. Now, depending on their difference, this generated error voltage will get amplified by this error amplifier, and it will act as a control voltage. Now the job of this control voltage is to shift the frequency of this VCO towards the frequency of input, so that this difference should get reduced. When this difference get reduced, this error voltage will be reduced, and eventually in this process the system will be locked. System will be locked in a sense both the frequency will become equal. When both frequency will become equal, they will try to see the difference of phase. Again, with the error voltage, is both the phase will also become equal, and then we'll say the system is locked. So during the process, when the error voltage is generated, we say the system is in capture range. Once the system is in capture range, the process continuously evolves in such a way that the difference of these two frequency will become lower and lower with each iteration, and after a while both the frequency will be equal. When both the frequency will be equal, after a while it will check whether there is a difference in phase and will say the system is locked. I hope it is clear.
Yes sir.
Har communication ka aaj aap log auto tune wagera karte, to uska logic behind that is a PLL. Okay, so coming out to the next slide, now there are different application. Okay, let's see. It is frequency modulation, stereo decoder, FM demodulation, then frequency synthesis and use in motor speed control, tracking filter, similarly FSK, demodulation of carrier frequencies. Like these applications are there. Out of this, some of the applications we'll discuss after a while. Now there are some terms associated with this that you should lock in range, capture range and pull in time. Now just see, two important definitions are there, lock in range and capture range. Pull in time is not that important, but with the PLL, these three definitions are very important. अब इसको थोड़ा समझने की कोशिश करते हैं। एक तो होता है कि कैप्चर रेंज और एक लॉक इन रेंज। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस सेइंग, वंस द पीएलएल इज लॉक्ड इट कैन ट्रैक फ्रीक्वेंसी चेंजेस इन द इनकमिंग सिग्नल। अभी जब भी जैसे दोनों फ्रीक्वेंसी और फेज जब इक्वल हो गया तो नाउ इट इज लॉक्ड। अब इनपुट में फ्रीक्वेंसी में अगर थोड़ा चेंज भी हो जाएगा तो इट कैन ट्रैक दैट फ्रीक्वेंसी। व्हाई इट इज सेइंग once the PLL is locked, it can track the frequency changes in the incoming signal. How we can define the lock in range? The range of frequencies over which the PLL can maintain lock. Just try to give the emphasis, I'm giving emphasis on maintain. The range of frequencies over which the PLL can maintain lock with the incoming signal is called the lock in range. ये कितने frequency के change तक के वो lock maintain कर सकता है? Suppose एक बार सिस्टम लॉक हो गया 1 किलो हर्ट्ज एंड नाउ इट कैन मेंटेन दैट लॉक इवन इफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज चेंजिंग मे बी से 1.2 किलो हर्ट्ज 1.3 किलो हर्ट्ज एंड सिमिलरली इन द डाउनसाइड 700 हर्ट्ज। तो 1 किलो हर्ट्ज के प्लस माइनस सपोज 300 कर रहा है वो, सो वी कैन से इट कैन मेंटेन लॉक अप टू प्लस माइनस 300 हर्ट्ज। सो दैट इज इट लॉक इन रेंज रफली। सो जस्ट लेट्स से वंस अगेन, once the PLL is locked, it can track. एक बार PLL lock हो जाए तो अगर input में अभी भी change आ रहा है तो it can maintain that. वो lock बना का बना रहेगा, उसी में वो lock करके रहेगा. Even if the input frequency is changing, तो whatever range of frequency it is able to maintain that lock is known as lock in range or tracking range. So this is usually expressed as a percentage of free running frequency of VCO. Suppose VCO की frequency 1 kHz थी, उसके वो 10% कर सकता है कि 20% कर सकता है, इस तरीके से lock in range define करते हैं। Now this thing will be more clearer when we see the definition of capture. और इस चीज को और मैं clear करूंगा जब इसका हम transfer characteristics देखेंगे। अब यहाँ पे तो ये चल नहीं रहा है मेरा PPT, समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि क्यों नहीं चल रहा है। Anyway, now capture range, the range of frequencies over which the PLL can acquire lock with the incoming signal is called the capture range. The range of frequencies over which the PLL can acquire, it can acquire the range of starting में जब आप input frequency दिए है और pre-running frequency set है, अब उस difference में कभी कभी वो capture range में आ ही नहीं पाता। क्यों? अगर उसकी range of frequency उसके capture range के बाहर है तो, अगर उसके अंदर आया तो once it captures, it tries to lock with the closed loop system. So we can say how much is the range of frequency that it can acquire is known by this parameter capture range. It is also expressed as a percentage of FOF, pre-running frequency. So this will be clear when we'll see the transfer characteristics. Okay, now there is one more parameter, pull-in time. It says only about the time. The total time taken by the PLL to establish lock is called the pull-in time. जब आपने प्री रनिंग पे चल रहा है और इनपुट अपन ने दे दिए और अब वो लॉक होने के लिए जितना कुछ टाइम लगाता है उसको बोलते हैं पुलिंग टाइम। सो पुलिंग टाइम इज डिफाइंड एज द टोटल टाइम टेकन बाय द पीएलएल टू एस्टैब्लिश द लॉक इज कॉल्ड द पुल इन टाइम। दिस डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट फैक्टर इट विल डिसाइड कि उन दोनों के बीच पर डिफरेंस अगर ज्यादा होगा तो थोड़ा ज्यादा टाइम लेगा, अगर वो डिफरेंस बहुत कम होगा तो फास्ट लॉक हो सकता है। तो दिस डिपेंड्स ऑन इनिशियल फेज एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू सिग्नल्स एज वेल एज ओवरऑल लूप गेन एंड लूप फिल्टर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। ओके, नाउ एक्चुअली जब आप बुक में या किसी चीज में आप जब ट्रांसफर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक देखेंगे, ट्रांसफर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक क्या होता है? इट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक बिटवीन आउटपुट एंड इनपुट। नाउ हियर क्या है, आउटपुट इज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कंट्रोल वोल्टेज एंड इनपुट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी चेंज। तो फ्रीक्वेंसी इनपुट फ्रीक्वेंसी जो लग रहा है वो लगा है। तो एक्स एक्सिस में मैंने FN दिखाया है और वाई एक्सिस में कंट्रोल वोल्टेज। ओके, अब देखो यहाँ पे क्या दिख रहा है, ये एक लेफ्ट साइड से यहाँ से जा रहा है, आप ये FO देख रहे हैं, FO, just observe the FO.
Yes, sir.
ये है फ्री रनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी, ये फ्री रनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी है, यानी VCO इज रनिंग एट फ्री रनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी। सो नो एरर वोल्टेज इज जनरेट, यहाँ पे कोई एरर वोल्टेज नहीं आया ऊपर, ठीक है। अब सपोज मैंने इनपुट सिग्नल अप्लाई किया, अगर इनपुट फ्रीक्वेंसी ये बहुत कम हुई, ये यहाँ पे लेफ्ट साइड में ये बिल्कुल यहाँ से ये फर्स्ट एरो जो दिख रहा है, फर्स्ट एरो प्लस ब्राउन एरो, सो ये इसके कैप्चर रेंज के क्वाइट डिफरेंस है, मतलब ये एफओ से ये बहुत फ्रीक्वेंसी डिफरेंस है। सो सिस्टम विल नॉट डू एनीथिंग, Now let us say input voltage frequency is increasing. Now I am increasing the frequency. आपको शिमिट ट्रिगर में जैसे हिस्टेरिसिस बताया था ना, वैसे यहाँ हिस्टेरिसिस आने वाला है, ठीक है? So just observe when I am increasing the frequency, even if the error voltage is not generated at certain frequency f1. Now can you observe the f1 frequency at least?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
F1 at certain frequency f1, when it comes to the capture range, see here the capture range is shown like this one, delta f cap. Okay, when it enters the capture range, depending on the difference of f4 and f1, the error voltage will be generated. Here the error voltage is shown in a negative, so ye error niche aa gaya, aap dekh rahe hain ye niche aa gaya, to itna vc control voltage develop ho gaya. Depending on that, now due to phase detector, the error voltage is generated, which will cause the free running frequency to move towards the input frequency. Thereby, the frequency difference will be lowered. And now, the less error voltage will be generated, and time will come when both the frequency will become equal. So here at the, you can say FO, both the frequency will be equal. Now, if the input frequency is again increased, the error voltage will be generated now, but in the positive side. If even the input frequency is increased, the error voltage will be more. If even the frequency is increased, the error voltage will be more. Still, it is able to log that thing. But after certain frequency at F2, it will lose the log and abruptly the error voltage will come to a zero voltage. And even if you are increasing the frequency, the error voltage will not be generated, and thereby only VCO will run at pre-running frequency. So what we observed earlier, the PLL which was running at pre-running frequency, when we give the input signal, if the input signal is having a very difference of frequencies between echo and input frequency, and if it is not coming into the capture range, no error voltage will be generated. When the frequency becomes equal or at F1, there will be a abrupt shoot of error voltage which will control, or which will apply as a control voltage to VCO, and due to that, this VCO frequency will try to attain the frequency of input. It will try to make a difference reduced. So with the each loop, the difference will be reduced. So now let us say at FO, both the frequency will be equal, and even if the input frequency we are increasing, then the error voltage will be generated, but in the other direction. And if the error voltage is more, there will be more control voltage. Like this, it goes on, it goes on. It can lock up to frequency F2, but after F2, it will lose the lock and no error voltage will be there. But now from this onward, if you are decreasing the frequency, now see the second graph. If you are decreasing the frequency, we will not get the system to be locked or in the capture range at the F2, but it will come to the F3, a lower, you can say, when there is a lower difference. So at certain frequency F3, there will be error voltage generated by, you can say, phase detector, which will generate addition and subtraction frequencies. Addition will be rejected by low pass filter and difference will be passed by the low pass filter, and that error voltage will act as a control voltage to the VCO. Thereby, it will try to log the input frequency with this one. So if the input frequency is again decreased, the time will come, both the frequency will be equal. If the input frequency is again decreased, the error voltage will be generated in the negative side, and it can lock that thing up to frequency F4. After that, if you have decreased the frequency, no error voltage will be generated, and we'll say system will be coming out of the lock. So what do we observe? These both the things, there is a hysteresis type of thing, means the input is coming into the capture range at certain another frequency F1, it can keep the lock up to frequency certain F2. When we decrease, it will capture at the F3, it can keep lock up to F4. So thereby, it gives a definition that the F capture is defined by the difference of F3 minus Fn. It is F3 minus this F1. So inner frequency is a capture one, and outer frequency, this F2 and F4, is a locking range. Okay, so if we combine this both the transfer characteristic, it will look like this one. So we can say here in this region, it is unpredictable whether it is coming in this or in that one. So that sort of that, in that way, we can say it is hysteresis occurs. So when the input signal we have applied, it won't generate, but once it comes to F1 frequency, error voltage is generated, thereby it will try to reduce the frequency towards the input frequency, and in this way it goes on and goes on. It can lock up to frequency F2. After F2, the lock will be collapsed. There will be no error voltage. Now suppose if we are decreasing the frequency, it won't respond till it comes to frequency F3. At that frequency F3, there will be error voltage generated, and it will try to reduce the difference of those two frequencies. It may be possible up to, this will keep the lock up to a frequency F4, after which it is not able to respond and the error voltage will be reduced. So this is the transfer characteristics of PLL. Hopefully I have explained this one. एक ध्यान दो, इस ट्रांसफर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स में जो दिखा रहा हूँ, PLL अगर वो PLL उसको ट्रैक नहीं कर पा रहा इनपुट को, तो वो फ्री रनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी पे चलेगा, यानी कौन सी फ्रीक्वेंसी F4। अब PLL की इनपुट में जो हमने सिग्नल दिया है उसकी अगर कैप्चर रेंज में आ जाए तो वो कुछ रिस्पॉन्ड करता है। तो हम क्या देख रहे हैं, अप टू F1 इट इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग। अगर ये F4 के थोड़ा नजदीक आ गया, मतलब F4 नजदीक है, F4 नजदीक नहीं है, तो ये रिस्पॉन्ड F4 पे नहीं कर रहा है, F1 पे कर रहा है। अब जैसे जैसे इनपुट फ्रीक्वेंसी हम इंक्रीज कर रहे हैं तो वो कुछ रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं कर रहा है, लेकिन एट फ्रीक्वेंसी F1 एरर वोल्टेज इज जनरेटेड। नाउ दिस एरर वोल्टेज एज वी नो विल एक्ट एज अ कंट्रोल वोल्टेज टू VCO, thereby it will try to change its frequency towards the input frequency. So now the difference will decrease. As the difference will decrease, error voltage will decrease. So at time, sometime, both the frequency will become equal. Even if suppose by some way input frequency is increasing, then the error voltage will be generated, that will try to reduce this frequency. And if error voltage is more, that will be due to more frequency. This goes on, it can lock up to a frequency of F2. But after F2 frequency, it will not respond. It will collapse. The system will come out of the lock and the error voltage will be reduced to zero. And PLL will again run at pre-running frequency. The same phenomena occurs when we are decreasing the frequency. Suppose we have applied a very high frequency, it is not responding, this PLL is not responding. जब तक क्या कि ये F4 to F2 के range में नहीं है, ये respond नहीं करता। तो जब lower हम frequency decrease कर रहे हैं, तो it won't respond till F3. जैसे ही F3 के नीचे होने लगे, तो there will be error voltage generated, which will try to make the pre-running frequency, try to make the difference of these two frequency to be zero, or we can say it will try to shift the pre-running frequency towards the input frequency. Thereby, this error voltage is generating. And now this error voltage will go on decreasing as both the frequencies are coming towards equal. At this FO frequency, both the frequencies are equal, so no error voltage is there. Again, if the input frequency is decreased, some error voltage will be generated, but in the opposite direction, we can say negative. So this will go on, it can track up to F4 frequency. After F4 frequency, it will lose the track and eventually the error voltage will be zero. So in this way, we see a phenomena first from F1 to F2, then we see the while decreasing F3 to F4, and thereby it gives rise to definition that F3 minus F1 is a double capture frequency, double of capture frequency, मतलब half FO के इधर साइड में एक और इधर साइड के एक, और similarly lock range F2 minus F4. So outer is a lock range, inner is a capture range. We can say capture range is less than lock range. So I suppose this is enough for the day. इसको हम बाद में और थोड़ा सा देखेंगे।